We start out this video always remembering the basics. Basics are is to say, I don't have a world problem, I have a continuity problem. Or I don't have a hallucination problem, I have a continuity problem. The hallucination problem has no value to me, only the vision of oneness has value to me. So welcome to the video. Start out in the mood of repentance, putting yourself in a blessed condition, saying, I don't have a world problem, I have a continuity problem. You're basically saying, all this is a dream, I know this, but I'm so used to dreaming, I need some help to overcome this continuity fear I have. I'm so used to hallucinating, I have a hard time to stop hallucinating. This is continuity problem. Say, okay, I have a continuity problem, but really what I'm hallucinating, I don't really have a problem with that at all, because it's not real. But I do have a problem in stopping hallucinating, to stop hallucinating. That's our problem, actually. We're hallucinating that there's this big, deep, dark pit, layers and levels. It's not there, actually. It's never been there. But we're so used to hallucinating it, we say, how do I stop hallucinating? This is very difficult. So we say, I do not have a hallucination problem. I do have a continuity problem. Okay. Puts you in the mood of repentance. It puts you in a blessed condition where you're able to hear, you're able to actually evaporate the continuity fear gradually. Okay, where others are still arguing, you're evaporating the fear. So it's all important to keep that in mind. Now, the last couple of videos, let me recapitulate just a little bit so you know where we're coming from. A couple videos ago, I am and am not the Jesus free Jesus. This was a breakthrough in showing how we can put a framework of concepts and words around the picture of the vision of oneness to help evaporate the continuity fear and gradually ease us into actually experiencing the actual picture of the vision of oneness. It's very doable. And so I was able to show using words in a very creative, unique way. Yes, this can be done. Now, it was a big strain. I paid a big price for that one because it's just so, I was discombobulated. My whole system was just, wow. And bouncing back a little bit from that. Also, the last video, what was it? Good lawyer, bad lawyer. The scam of existence, fully revealed. Okay, now this is very important, very important. And I showed how we keep getting tricked over and over again and go through more, cycle after cycle after cycle. And we have to, at some point, see through the whole scam. The best time to do it, a great time, is when there's a transition from one lawyer to the other. See, the prosecution, what is happening is we're putting ourselves on the witness stand, what we've done. And the prosecution is saying, how did you get out of this pit? In other words, taking the hallucination to be real, that there is this layers and levels, pit of layers and levels, instead of the zero dimensionality of pure spaciousness, that somehow pure spaciousness has dimension to it, layers and levels, which is not true. And we say, how did you get out of this pit? You know, how did you manage to do this? We've been interrogating ourselves for so long, viciously. But what we do, we have a team now. These bodies that we have are really these rehearsal suits. I call them rehearsal suits. They're just suits that we put on because we're rehearsing to prepare to get into another realm, a realm beyond God. That's the original idea is, Spirit said, you know what? I wonder if there's something beyond God. I want to go in search of this and find it. I want to be greater than God. Maybe there's some secret realm God's not telling us about. We want to find it. So we put on these rehearsal suits called bodies. We made these, we imagined these bodies. We hallucinated a whole training program. And this world form, all form, world, all of this bodies is this training program. And we're trying to get used to the idea of getting into another realm that's separate from God. It's a different realm. That's why we die, actually. Dying to this realm is practicing so we can leave reality and die, like leave it and go into the next realm, higher realm, which doesn't even exist. Doesn't exist. So these rehearsal, these bodies, body suits, rehearsal suits we have, okay. Well, we have male rehearsal suits, female rehearsal suits, same thing. They're both rehearsal suits for how to get into a non-training, preparing to get into a non-existent reality, a non-existent dimension. Reality is zero dimensional. Okay, there are no dimensions to reality. It's all one. And so this rehearsal is for nothing. It's much ado about nothing. Now, but we are very tricky, and we say, Spirit, put you on the witness stand. We just want to know, okay, you're talking about the spiritual zero dimensionality, blah, 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 that's great. Just tell us, how did you get out of this pit? How did you get out of this dimensionality? How did you figure it out? What did you do? How did you do it? Just tell us, tell us, tell us. What we're really saying is, this pit is real, but how did you escape it? It's real, but how did you escape it? We're happy you escaped it, but just how did you do it? And Spirit, of course, has no answer for this because it's not real. There was no escape. You just simply realize you've been hallucinating. It was never there. Not really there. Not really there. We're just superimposing this notion of layers and levels upon the oneness, actually. It's a hallucination. Projection. Now, we're following this court case. Are witnessing, we're paying attention to it, and the lawyers are, now what happens is the lawyers are a team, I said, male-female team, okay, this is very important, male-female team, they're a team, and the male lawyer, or the female, or let's say the male lawyer is interrogating the witness, Spirit, you're gonna tell me, I'm gonna beat it out of you, you know, how dare you not tell me, I want you to tell me, you know, you understand, you know, that, yelling, screaming, you gotta tell me, and all this stuff. So, the male lawyer has been interrogating the witness for what, a couple thousand years or so. Doesn't work, because Spirit has no answer. It cannot say how it got out of nowhere. It didn't get out of anything. It was never in it. So it's a trick question. It's a trick question. It's basically trying to get God to say God isn't God. You know, truth isn't true. Okay, so. We start to realize, wow, this isn't working. And then we start to say, hey, you know, maybe there is no answer. Maybe, you know, and we start to wake up. That's how it happens. We start to study really in-depth the spirituality and say, hey, wait a minute. Maybe this is just all a hallucination. Maybe this witness does not answer because there is no answer. Maybe, okay. Now, what is the defenses against that? The ego wants to keep us in this training program, okay? He wants to make the pit real, but then how do we get out of this pit? He wants to make the pit real, meaning there is some other realm. There is some other realm. This pit would be another realm, actually, if it was true. So we reach this point where the male lawyer, we realize, wow, this is, cannot break the witness. That's terrible. Well, how are we ever going to get the answer? Okay, what happens is the team does a switcheroo. And in comes the female lawyer. Okay, this is very, very key. This is the last video covered this in depth. I'm kind of making sure that you're up to speed on this. The female lawyer comes in and says, wow, I'm so glad I'm here. You know, the other lawyer, what a jerk. What an absolute jerk. It's unbelievable. Wouldn't let me say anything all this time. If I'd have just been able to talk with you, witness, this court case could have been over. Thousand years ago. I mean, I was completely suppressed and repressed. Couldn't say a word. It was absolutely terrible. This guy is just the worst lawyer. I hate him. It's terrible. You know, I'm on your side, witness. My God, it's great to see you, you know. And I'm so empathetic and compassionate and consensus building. And I got God in my heart and everything. You know, I'm just, so you can tell me, you know, I mean, you don't want to talk to that other jerk lawyer, do you? So you can give me the answer. It shouldn't be a problem at all for you. Just I'm actually only asking for a very little thing. So, you know, the whole spiel, you know, of the female lawyer now comes in. Okay, and remember, I'm speaking to you as Spirit, not as the body suit here. We are not the body suit. These body suits are just rehearsal suits for to practice getting to some other realm which doesn't even exist. We're spirit, we're free, we are as God created. You know, I am spirit, I am free, I am still as God created me. It goes for everyone. So we have to see through this scam, okay? Good lawyer, bad lawyer scam. So the female lawyer side comes in and says, wow, I got good news for everybody. And the female lawyer talks to the world and says, you know what, folks? I got great good news for you. Spirit's gonna give us the answer. I just know. It's my female intuition. I just know we're gonna get it because it's destiny, right? And this other, we failed only because this terrible jerk male lawyer, it was totally incompetent and evil and harsh, and the witness just didn't want to confide in him, you know? I mean, who would anyway? I mean, he's such a terrible jerk, right? Who would want to ever confide in that? But guess what? I'm so nice and wonderful that for sure the witness is going to finally tell me the secret. So we can all prepare for a golden age because for sure it's coming. Guaranteed, you know. That's what the female lawyer tells the world. Okay. And then she says, okay. I told everybody the golden age is coming. I told that you're going to save everybody. I told them the case is going to be dismissed. You're going to be able to tell me. And so we're just... anytime you're ready, you know, I'm no pressure, no problem. Just anytime you're ready, you can tell me, you can tell me. And, of course, there's nothing to tell. There's nothing to tell. You see how this works? Now, all the pressure has been put on the witness saying, hey, the golden age is right around the corner. I told everybody you're going to tell me. And so it's if you don't, it's all your fault. The things go bad. You see that? Puts the pressure on, severe pressure, right? So it doesn't work. Other thousands and thousands of years go by where you keep saying, well, it's, you know, making excuses. How come the witness didn't give the right answer and everything? Finally, everybody runs out of patience and the whole thing, you know, then what happens? Ah, the male lawyer appears again and says, hey, world, I'm here. I haven't been able to say anything because I've been completely suppressed. But the fact is this female lawyer, she's completely incompetent. She doesn't have the right approach at all. You know, she wasn't forceful enough or whatever. And then there's another switch over. And now it's the male lawyer's in charge. And everyone's, and he says, for sure, I'm gonna beat it out of this witness or whatever. and on it goes, switching back and forth like this. On and on it goes. There is no answer for the witness. How did I get out of this pit? There's no pit. How did I get out of all these layers and levels? There are no layers and levels. Spirit didn't get out of anything. So it's a wrong question. It doesn't matter the style the question's being asked in, it's the wrong question. So whether it's a male style or a female style, it's the wrong question for both. See, this is what I'm getting at. This is what we're getting at here. Now, so this is, happens to be the time when the female lawyer is taking over. So of course I have to comment on this. So it may seem like I'm, you know, saying, hey, the women, the female lawyers, this whole, you know, feminism, all this stuff, which is the female lawyer taking over the case here, the witness, taking over the witness. It's all wrong. Well, it is all wrong. And it just happens to be that this is the female lawyer. Now, if it was the male lawyer taking over from the female, I'd be saying the same thing. This is false, this is a scam, the question is wrong. Question is wrong question. It's misleading, completely misleading. You're never going to get an answer. This is a delaying tactic. It's a delaying tactic. So it may seem like, oh, I'm very negative on the women and I don't like feminism. Well, I don't like the scam. See, I don't like the scam. I'm pointing out what the scam is of existence. And male and female, both are two parts of the scam, you see? Both of them. The problem is right now, is during this changeover period, we have this honeymoon period where everyone thinks, oh, finally, we're going to get the answer, and it's going to be, we'll be happy forever, forevermore. We're going to have a golden age. This is great. Finally, we're going to get the answer. It's the honeymoon period. When there's a switcheroo, is a honeymoon period. And that honeymoon period is when you drop your defenses, you drop your spiritual vigilance during this honeymoon period. This is what the problem is right now. It has been for the last 50 years, and I've been trying to warn people about this is you drop your vigilance, you drop your spiritual path, you say, hey, why should I have to work so hard? The witness is going to tell this female lawyer for sure. We'll get the answer of how to escape this pit, and everyone's going to be happy in golden age, come all be enlightened. You see, they drop their vigilance, they drop their vigilance, they drop the spiritual path. Okay. Now, I was one who did not drop the spiritual path. I said, there's something phony about this whole situation. I don't trust it. And I'm going to keep on keeping on full blast, because at some point we're going to find out what the trick is, and we found out what it is now. But many have gone into this honeymoon period, and hopefully they're waking up. Hopefully they're waking up. Hopefully they're here because they're saying, hey, wait a minute here. This might be a scam. You know, this whole situation of existence, we're going into this wonderful new age, golden age. I said, wait a minute, it doesn't look like that's what's really happening at all. You know, are we really getting answers that we really want? No. But it can be, you know, the marketing campaign is overwhelming of like, here comes the Savior, she's here. You know, the Savior is here. Female lawyer's here, she's saving, gonna save the day for sure. Because God, fine, get rid of that terrible male lawyer, such a failure, what a jerk that guy is. You know, he just, as I said, the commercials are virtually without, almost, you know, virtually, totally, the female's always good, right, has the answer, has the right style, the right approach. The male always has the wrong approach. Okay, this is the whole marketing campaign of the world is this way. The man's approach just, you know, is out of date, out of style, doesn't work, is stupid, bumbling, he's a jerk, and here's the female with the answer. She's got it. That's the female lawyer. It's being marketed globally and has been for quite some time, actually. And the Holy Spirit showed me this. He says, look at this. I said, yeah, I see it. Why? What's going on here? Holy Spirit said, you'll find out eventually, but just pay attention and see what this marketing campaign, how it's being structured. And I saw it and I said, wow, that's weird, that's scary, that what is going on here? Now we know what's going on. But the honeymoon period, they're trying to keep it going, kind of keep it going. Like, folks, we are in for the most wonderful, you know, it's going to be great when we finally, the case is finally closed here. This whole case can be closed. Just as soon as we get the answer from Spirit, how it escaped from this pit, the whole case is dismissed. We can now be happy forevermore. It's going to be perfect. Don't worry. See, this is the advertising. And the female lawyer is now the hero. The heroine has been already anointed as the heroine. She's here. She's here. The heroine is here. The female lawyer is here. She's going to, for sure, the witness will confide in her. There's no question, right? Nobody even doubts it. Well, this is the scam that's been going on in perpetuity. Okay. Remember, before the male lawyer took over, it was the female lawyer back in the matriarchy times for a long time. And then the male lawyer took over because they didn't get the answer from the female lawyer, right? So it's been going back and forth, and dragging us, keel-hauling us through, you know, the mud of history, the atrocities of history, and we'll continue to be keel-hauled through it if we don't wake up and accept I have a continuity problem. That's the first step in waking up. I don't have a witness problem. I have a continuity problem, okay? I don't have a case problem. I have a continuity problem. I don't have a lawyer problem. I have a continuity problem. The witness has nothing to say to that question. It's a trick question. How did you escape? There is no escape, because we're not in any pit. We're not in anything to escape from. We're hallucinating. But how do you escape that? You stop hallucinating. But how do you do that? Because you have a continuity fear, so you evaporate the continuity fear. You don't escape the content of a hallucination within the hallucination. You realize that all the content of hallucination was equally untrue. Equally untrue. No past, no depth to it. No past, no storylines. None of it was relevant in the slightest bit. Okay, so here we are. And see if I can go forward at this point. So I just want to point out that during these times, you have to be, if you're going to be relevant to what's going on, you have to talk about what's going on. And I certainly have been. It feels like a team. This prosecution is a team. Male-female, all right? One team. And they pretend to be antagonistic to each other, to give the good lawyer, bad lawyer dynamic, so they think they'll trick the witness into thinking, oh, wow, okay, that terrible lawyer was badgering me for so long. They're not really on the same side. This one's on my side, you know? You cannot trick spirit like that, but we think it's very tricky. And so I have to give relevant testimony and witnessing to the times we're in. So I most certainly point out that the goddess cult is coming into this world. The goddess cult is the cult around this female lawyerism, so to speak. This prosecution of the witness, of getting the answer. Okay, it basically means the female, the goddess cult, new world order goddess cult, is all this belief and support for the female lawyer, the female prosecutor, the one who supposedly is going to finally get the secret from the witness. And so everyone in the world being told, you gotta support her, because she's the one who's gonna do it. And so the world is really a cult. It's a feminist cult of believing that women are the ones who are gonna get the answer. Like somehow they have something in them which is going to, you know, they have God within their heart and the intuition and empathy and compassion and consensus and the right touch and the right approach. And we're being brainwashed thinking, for sure, this is gonna work. What are we really being brainwashed into? Delay. Into another cycle, okay, of waiting for the witness to answer the question, and the witness cannot give an answer to the question, okay, because the question is, how did you escape this pit? And there is no pit, you see, is the answer. The prosecution won't accept that. No, I said, how did you escape? Meaning, first accept the illusion as real, and then tell us how you escaped it. This is the deception. The prosecution is saying, first admit the illusion is real, then tell us how you escaped it. That is the question. How did you escape this pit? You see? So it doesn't matter whether there's a male lawyer, it doesn't matter if there's a patriarchy badgering the witness, or a matriarchy trying to seduce the witness. Hey, witness, you know, look at me, you know, you can tell me, it's going to be so happy, you're going to be so happy telling me, I know you're going to love telling me, I'm so wonderful, you can confide in me, you know. So you get all these female talk shows, you know, of people coming on and confiding in the woman, and as the woman as the great therapist, you know, she's here, the great therapist here, now she's going to go to the spirit and say, spirit, look at everybody confiding in me, everybody trusts me. You can trust me too, Spirit. Just tell me how you got out of here. You know, just tell me. And Spirit, of course, the truth is, you can't make illusions true. Okay? You cannot make illusions true and then escape them. You can't escape truth. To make an illusion true, if you were to say illusion is true, you couldn't escape it. So there's no answer to the question. Doesn't matter how much the whole world is backing this, you know, the female lawyer. Doesn't matter in the slightest bit. It's a waste of time. So at what point are we going to see through the scam? Are we going to go through another cycle? And then the next cycle is the males are going to take over again from the females and say, hey, those females botched it. They fiddled around and thought they were so great and they could seduce the witness. That's not the way to do it. I'm going to approach the witness in a straightforward, honest manner, you know. And at that point, you know, everyone will be told, back the male, back the patriarchy. This is what is right. And if you try to speak up then, everybody will say, wow, what's the matter? You're anti-male? That's terrible, you know. It just goes on and on and on and on and on like this. So you have to speak up and bring to light the whole dualistic scam. And see is one scam. They're in total cahoots. The male-female lawyers are completely in cahoots. They know exactly how to orchestrate this dance. It's a dance of deception, thinking that they can deceive spirit into answering the question. And what we're saying here is there is no answer to the question. How did I escape? How did I escape the pit, you know? How did I escape this illusion, you know, as if it were true? You can't make the illusion true and then escape it, all right? If it's an illusion, you're never there. Spirit's never been in a pit, actually. The fact that we've been hallucinating there's a pit doesn't mean we're in it. Doesn't mean we're in it. So you cannot say, how did you get out of it? Okay. You can say, I was never in it. Yes. But that's not the question they're asking. They're saying, you were in it. How did you get out of it? See, that's what they're saying. How did you get out of this reality and back to some other reality? How did you do that? Didn't do it. Did not do it. You see what we're getting at here? So there are a lot of those who watch these videos who have these female training suits on, right? Female bodies, female training suits on, and it's very good to know. I hope that they're seeing the big picture. Both male and female are seeing the big picture. Actually, what's being said here? Hey, it's good lawyer, bad lawyer, male lawyer, female lawyer, playing this dance of deception, this scam, which is giving us false hope that they're going to get the answer for us. The ego is going to get the answer for us, and then we'll be happy. This is false hope, false hope, false hope. Okay, so it doesn't, whether you have a female training suit, rehearsal suit, or a male rehearsal suit, it's exactly the same. Okay, it's exactly the same. There is no pit. Exactly the same. There is no pit. Therefore, there is no one who's going to get the answer from spirit. How did you get out of the pit? Doesn't matter whether it's a male or female training student who's trying to get the answer. Whether it's the patriarchy or the matriarchy, neither one. Both of them 100% failure. 100% failure. 100% failure. From failure from the very beginning. There's never been any possibility of success at this. And you think in this world, most of the men are actually totally backing the matriarchy now. Like, oh yeah, the matriarchy's going to get us the answer for sure. So you know, it's amazing there are men watching these videos too. Male rehearsal suits, right? Because most males are very strongly backing the matriarchy and the goddess cult at this time. Very strongly. Okay? Absolutely. And they're saying, oh no, they're going to get the answer. They're so much better than we are. They're so nice. They're so, God is with them. They're special, you know. And it's just absolute nonsense, utter nonsense. They will never get the answer. Nobody will get the answer. No combination, no trickery, no good lawyer, bad lawyer can ever get an answer which doesn't exist. How did spirit get out of this realm? Spirit's never in any realm. Spirit's abides in reality. There's only reality. There's only the oneness. There isn't any other. How did you get out of the other back to reality? That's a ridiculous question. It can't be answered. There is no other. And everybody wants to be a hero in this world. You know, it's like, we want to back a winner. There are no winners in this questioning. Only losers. Only losers. Because there's no answer. All we're doing is waiting for an answer that will never come. Okay, as we're watching this court case. So what do? You be the defense lawyer and say, hey, I have a question for you, witness. My turn. Just say, my turn, prosecution. Were you ever in any pit at all? Witness. Answer, no. So are there any pits at all, actually, in reality? No. Case dismissed. Thank you. It's over. So this is where we've been. Now, what to do with this video, with this one. I gotta try to remember where I was, what I was going for, but it will come. I just want everybody to shift out of this duality of male-female duality. That's the trick. That's the trick. And it doesn't make any difference. I'm not talking about, you know, the good lawyer, bad lawyer that can be played in many ways. They can have some androgynous person interrogating the witness. That doesn't, not gonna work, is it? They're gonna have some, you know, all different varieties of male, female interrogating the witness. Oh, don't worry, you know, we've got this, you know, orientation interrogating. That'll work. Oh, we have this orientation. Oh, we have this orientation, you know, the whole gamut, right, is saying, don't worry, one of these lawyers is gonna get the job done. No, they won't. No, they won't. Oh, that's heresy to say that. You know, it's heresy. Blasphemous. How can you say that? Where's your hope? You're not backing, you know, you're negative or something. No, I'm truthful. Truthful, truthful, truthful. Saving us. Delay, saving us needless delay, waiting for an answer that will never come. Okay, and so they're just trying all these combinations. Okay, what kind of combination? What kind of lawyer can we get up there that the people will back, you know, and say, okay, you're gonna get it for sure. And they're just frantic, you know, frantic to come up with something to keep catching our attention. But a lot of us are saying, wait a minute, maybe this is all completely bogus, totally bogus. Yeah, that's what Jesus tells us. It's all bogus. Okay. How do we see through the scam? Well, I was helped by Jesus and others. But, you know, Jesus was primarily helped me out a lot through A Course in Miracles and Journey Beyond Words. And just the overall flavor of the wisdom, of the understanding, and you know, the fundamentals. You know, the way out, you can't make illusions true and then escape from them. This is one of his big clear emphasis. You can't make illusions true and then escape from them. That is exactly what we're trying to do. Exactly. Okay, because as soon as, if we were make this illusion true, we couldn't escape from it. And that's what the ego wants. It wants us to not escape from this pit, this imaginary pit. Because it, then that would prove it's a different realm. Hey, we do. There is another realm. Here we are. You know, so we're trying to make illusions true and then escape from them. Cannot do it. So I recommend those other two videos. I am and am not Jesus, the Jesus Free Jesus, which is a very creative video. It knocked me out for a couple days. Really knocked me out. And then Good Lawyer, Bad Lawyer, The Scam of Existence, Fully Revealed. Very, very informative videos. Always worth repeating the central truth, isn't it? Again, say, I don't have a good lawyer, bad lawyer problem. I have a continuity problem. I don't have a hallucination problem. I have a continuity problem. See, I don't have a delay problem. I have a continuity problem. It immediately puts you in a blessed condition. Immediately puts you in a blessed condition. You'll feel it. You'll say, hey, wow, I feel somehow centered differently. I feel like I'm a different center. I'm not really in this drama. I'm not really centered in this courtroom anymore. I feel like I'm outside the courtroom, you know. And then I can listen to this witness, and then I can get used to seeing them as not really a witness at all. They didn't have any answers. How could they be a witness? What are they a witness to? And I'm not no longer a spectator of a witness either. And then gradually the visions between spectator and witness begin to gradually melt away. And then you realize, this is just all one spirit. There's just one spirit. Like that. The continuity problem will gradually melt away, evaporate away. Gradually. And see, the ego wants us to keep on waiting for the answer and say, no, you can do it immediately. As soon as we get the answer, we're all going to be happy. As soon as we get the answer, we're all going to be happy. So the graduated path of everydayness, the ego hates that. It ain't said, it says, don't you have any faith in this female lawyer? She's going to break this witness. She's going to seduce this witness. This witness is going to confide in her for sure. And as soon as that happens, everyone's going, the world's going to be happy. This is their spiel. This is their belief. Okay. And here I am, you know, what an idiot I am. I've been grinding in the spiritual path out for 36 years. The anniversary now, August of 2014, 36 years now. Started in August of 1978, really intensely. I was always on the path since I was 12, but the real super intensity has been 36 years of super intensity, grinding it out every day. And the ego's just been saying, what an idiot you are. What an idiot. You don't need to do that. As soon as this witness gives us the secret, we'll share it with everybody, and it'll be instant happiness for everyone. I never even had to do all that stuff. And I said, hey, ego, I think you're lying. I think you're lying. My teachers are telling me you're lying. They're saying, grind it out every day. Okay. So that, you gradually evaporate the continuity fear. Gradually, I'm still doing it. I'm still doing it. But it's tough to speak like this in the world. I have backlashes, and I just almost come unglued because the ego is putting such incredible pressure on everyone of expectations that to speak up like this is just unbelievably difficult, actually. Because you feel like nobody's with you. You know, that's the feeling. Like nobody's going to go with you. Everybody's going to say, hey, wait a minute. We don't have to grind it out like this. As soon as this witness breaks, everybody's going to be saved. That's what the ego tells us. It's a lie, because there's nothing to break. There is no answer. So you're going to be caught up in another cycle if you keep waiting like this. And once you get caught in the cycle, what happens is everybody's so believing into it, then the female lawyer, for instance, in this cycle, the goddess cult cycle, will say, hey, you know what? We just, the witness is actually confiding in me. Starting to confide, they're starting to, you know, it's really close, and the witness just wants you to, if you do a little something, you know, to make the witness feel more comfortable. So the female lawyer will start telling you all this stuff. It's all a lie. It's all a lie. Okay, she'll say, you need to structure society this way, you need to structure it this way, you need to act this way, you need to have these kind of thoughts, you need to stop saying these things because this witness is ready to talk, is ready to spill the beans. I'm telling you, it's ready to spill the beans, but it just asks, well, one little thing, if you people would stop saying negative things about the lawyer or me or whatever, you know, you can just be nice, just everybody be nicer, this. Every day you get this, the lawyer saying, hey, you know, this is, we're just that close to now. If you could just do this little thing, what you find out is thousands and thousands of years of you making little adjustments until you're just like, you know, so completely brainwashed. You have no idea what's going on. It's all a complete scam. Okay. It's the ego trying to use this idea that the witness is just about ready to break to get you to start making all these adjustments away from the spiritual path, the everyday grinded out spiritual path, which you must do to evaporate the continuity problem. The ego leads you away from that, says, just wait, stop work. You know, what the female lawyer will say, and the male lawyer too, but we're here in the female, we might as well talk about the goddess cult, because that's what's happening now. The goddess cult will say, hey, you know, this witness, it started to tell me the secret, but the last second they something blocked them. You know, they were blocked. And I said, what's wrong? And what's the blockage? And then the female is like, oh, I see the blockage. I understand you. I'm empathic, compassionate and empathic. I understand the blockages. Is you have all these people in the world who are believing that you're not going to tell the secret. You're not going to tell that there isn't any secret. That's horrible. They need to stop doing that. I understand it's hurting your feelings. Okay, I'm going to make sure everybody in the world stops all the spiritual practice and believing of Jesus, what Jesus had to say and all this stuff, because that's hurting you, witness. It's really hurting you. And so she then tells the world that this is what the witness said. Okay, and everyone says, oh my God, okay. Hey, everybody, knock it off. No more talk about this. Clarity Rise, shut up, you know. you can't say any more of this because the witness is ready to speak. If you just quiet for a little while, the witness will speak. This is all 100% lies, made up lies, bogus lies, to delay, and to get you to stop your spiritual practice, okay? The witness never said anything like that whatsoever. The witness doesn't have any blocks. What? Make illusions true and then escape them. There is no such answer. There's no answer to how do you make illusions true at all. You cannot. How do you make a hallucination true? You can't. So, the spirit's never been in the pit. So how could it ever escape the pit? There's no escape from what doesn't exist. Okay, so you're getting the fullness now of this scam. It is an intense scam. And what it does is it puts pressure on everybody to shut up. Anyone who's witnessing to the grinded out path, okay, tell them to shut up. Because that's what the ego wants, actually. It's not what the witness wants, it's what the ego wants. But the witness reports it as if this is coming from the witness and they're ready to speak. You see what I'm saying? And this puts the pressure on the whole society, whole world culture. And what's happening now is they're using all these setups. The prosecution has all these helpers, actually. And, you know, you'll get some guy who will say something that the goddess cult doesn't like or something. And they just slam him, you know, absolutely slam him. This is happening almost every single day. Some guy somewhere is getting absolutely slammed because he said something that irritated the female lawyer, so to speak. But it's a setup, okay? This is all a setup. And then they'll say, you know, how dare you? I was just ready to get the answer, but this broke my concentration. I got nervous. You know, you undermined me or something. Oh, so, you know, here's a severe penalty for you. You got to shut up. Make sure you never say anything like that again. Apologize, fines, lose your job, you know, vilified. And then maybe I'll get my confidence back to ask this question, you know, press the witness more. And they say, oh, I'm sorry. It's the worst mistake of my life. I'm terrible. I'm so sorry. I'm dreadfully. And everybody's watching this, you know, and saying, oh my God, that's what I need to do. Okay, I need to just shut up and apologize. And I don't dare, you know, say anything. It's all a setup. It's a setup. Okay, these people are working for the prosecution. They're working for the prosecution, these people that you see in the media apologizing to them. I'm so sorry, you know, I undermined your case, you know, lawyer, dear lawyer, oh, so awful. And so everybody sees that and they say, wow, it's horrible what they did. What's the right thing to do? Well, shut up and apologize. I'll never say anything again. You know, that, okay, that's what I gotta do. This is a scam, 100% a scam. Okay. But I don't know how much longer I can keep speaking because the pressure is just, you know, it's just like insane pressure. Is how dare anybody, you know, undermine the lawyer's confidence, you know, she says, oh, the reason I'm failing is because you don't believe in me. You don't think I'm perfect. You know, if you just believe I'm perfect, then I'm sure I'll get the answer, you know. The perfect approach to the impossible, the perfect approach to the non-existent, isn't that what Spirit's trying to do? Is find the perfect approach to the secret realm beyond reality. And the reason why we haven't found it is we don't have the perfect approach yet. We don't have the confidence yet. So if we all believe, yeah, okay, you'll find it, you'll get it. You think, will that work? Or is that a lie? Is that self-deception? See, is that self-deception? And if it's self-deception, don't we say then, I don't have a self-deception problem anymore, right? I don't have one anymore. I don't have a self-deception problem. I have a continuity problem, though, now. See, I got a continuity problem. That's great. Thank you, God. It's the only problem that I have. Self-deception problem has no value to me. Only the vision of oneness has value to me. Case dismissed. Now work on the continuity problem. So are you getting the flavor of the world? This is what's happening. This is what is happening in this world. And I've been ceaselessly pointing it out. You know, either you speak truth or you speak lies. Either you speak truth or you speak lies. There's nothing else. There's no other option. It's one or the other. And the world is speaking lies. And if you're going to speak truth, you're going to be pointing out their lies. And they're going to be saying, you're undermining our case. No, I'm not. How can you underline a case that doesn't exist? I'm saying you're badgering the witness. You're badgering a witness that doesn't have an answer for you. You're bullying the witness. You're badgering the witness. You're intimidating the witness. You're trying to intimidate the witness. You're holding the witness here against their will, so to speak. Understand the context here. We're talking about the hallucination here. You know, we don't have to get all sophisticated about it because we're getting to the main point here. You're badgering, bullying, holding the witness. You're saying, hey, and you're hogging the witness and you're filibustering the witness. You're not giving me a chance to ask the witness a question, so I'm going to ask a question right now. I don't care what your objections are. They'll be screaming, hey, you're undermining, you're being misogynistic, you're undermining the female lawyer, that's not fair, you're not being fair, give her a chance, give her an opportunity, give her a couple thousand years, and say, no, I got a question right now. This has been going on for eons, actually. She's had her chance in previous times over and over and over. So my question to the witness is, were you ever in any pit? Were you ever in any pit? Oh, no? Okay, thank you. Are there any pits at all? Oh, no? Thank you. Okay, case dismissed. Boom. Finished. This is how to go about it. So we're just building on this clarity, building on the clarity. Same hand, the pressure is becoming absolutely insane in this world. Now, the world events that are going to happen are going to add to the pressure, because it's going to add to this feeling like we got to break this witness now. We've got to get the answer now. So everybody's got to get on the same page, put all our hope and faith in this female lawyer. She's going to do it for us. And anybody who doesn't is basically exacerbating the situation and making it worse. And it goes to pariah. You know, they're a pariah. Social pariah completely. So this, I can feel this, you know, it's like, wow, this is really a scary scenario going forward. So, and this is going to happen very soon. The crises are coming, and maybe even by tomorrow, August 5th, is a very good crisis day, as a matter of fact. The Jewish people know about this day because they'll be celebrating the day, a mourning, actually, throughout history. This date, not this date, but this, they have a calendar which happens to put a celebration on this date, August 5th, but it happens to land on different dates in different years. But during this particular celebration, this is when all the bad stuff has happened throughout history to the Jews, very bad stuff. You know, very severe situations have arisen. So it won't be a surprise if something very severe happens on August 5th. But whatever date happens, the pressure is becoming more and more severe as we got to break the witness now. Okay, that's the feeling. Gotta do it now, or else all hell's gonna break loose in the world. Because we think the only way to have peace and happiness in the world is to get the secret of how to escape this pit from the witness. But of course, what we really want to find out is how to figure out how did this witness escape, so we can block off and cement those escape hatches forever, and there can never be any escape. And then we think that once we have blocked off all escape and lost all hope of any escape, then we will suddenly realize, hey, this is where I am. This is where I have to be happy. And we'll all work together in a peaceful way, and we'll all be happy, and we'll have a golden age, and we figure out how to live in this pit happily ever after. This is all coordinated. The changeover of the female lawyer, the good lawyer, bad lawyer thing, the crises in the world, the pressure in the world, the disintegration of civilization, all this kind of stuff, the instability, it's all blueprinted and designed, again, to ultimately figure out a way how to keep ourselves trapped in this pit forever, a pit that doesn't even exist, by figuring out how spirit escaped from it, and then blocking the escape hatch off, so we'll, you know, no chance to ever escape, and then we'll just adjust to this, the new facts of this new realm, so to speak. All a dream, all a hallucination, we've never been in any pit at all. And the vision of oneness shows us. We see it, literally see it. I've literally seen it. My God, no one's ever been in any pit at all. I saw all these bodies standing, just standing everywhere throughout the world, and just kind of like light bodies, sort of, just standing, like sort of inert, you know, just standing. Everyone's just standing around, like waiting for something. And I noticed that, my God, nobody's in any pit at all. Everyone's on equal ground. There's never been any pit. Everyone's perfectly fine. And I was so happy. It was like the most incredible experience ever, for sure. I was overwhelmed with happiness. I was overwhelmed. That's why I'm not in the right now. It was so overwhelming. It was. I felt this joy, happiness growing and growing. I felt, my God, it's going to completely overwhelm me and sweep me away into just an ecstatic, continually ecstatic condition. So I said, wow, wait a minute. This is intense. I was just completely happy, pure happiness. I saw nobody's in any pit at all. There is no pit for anyone, for the entire creation. There is no pit. There's zero dimensionality. We're all on equal ground. We are one family. All of us are one family. Just one perfect family, without any possibility of any family member ever falling into any pit whatsoever. This is what made me so happy. None of my family is ever going to fall into, my one family is ever going to fall into any pit, ever. All have eternal life, perfect, clear, pure, eternal life. I saw it, experienced it for sure. But is no guarantee that I'm not going to be beat down by the pressure of this world. There's no guarantee at all. I already feel beat down, you know, very badly. It's super tough to go against the current at this time, for sure. So any encouragement that people give me is actually very welcome, actually. Yeah. Any encouragement, you know. It's a big help. Just a little word of encouragement, you know, for those who kind of get it. You know, I can't imagine that there aren't those who kind of get this, you know, or some who really get it, but basically kind of hear this and say, I sort of feel what's being said here. Yeah. Yeah. And once you have the vision of oneness, then you really can push this forward. Really can push it forward. But staying in the vision of oneness, I felt it was going to be overwhelming for me. Now, there are those who abide in it continuously, but those are the great, you know, the great sages that we, of legend, you know, Jesus, Anandamayi, Ramana Maharshi, Longchenpa, etc. They are abiding in that total realization all the time. And they can withstand any pressure. They can withstand any pressure. Nothing, it's nothing to them. They don't even feel the pressure. But someone like myself who is feeling, wow, that happiness is like too intense, overwhelming. Well, how do I abide in that? So I'm feeling the pressure from the world, most definitely. There's no guarantee at all. I don't have any guarantee I'm going to succeed withstanding the pressure. I'm certainly trying. But I feel like barely functional, stumbling around, my equilibrium's off, balance is off, my legs feel dead, and I feel just like I'm disintegrating, you know, from the stress. Because when the crises start, the whole world will want to say, hey, we've got to all pull together here, get on one page, who do we back? Ah, we're backing this, okay, the female lawyer, she's told she's going to break the witness, we believe it, everyone's going to have to support her. 100%, 100%, 100%, because we think that's the only route to salvation we have from this chaos that's coming. This is a scam. This is a trick. Chaos is on purpose to get you to buy into another cycle of delay, of going 100% in on backing this prosecution team and to drop your spiritual practice altogether. This is what it's really about. This is what it's really about. course, all the suffering and misery in the world is part of the rehearsal training to die to reality so you can get into this other realm, to somehow leave reality. The idea of dying is just basically leaving, you know, leaving one realm to go to another. So we've invented this imaginary, hallucinated, this realm and other realms, and we think we die here, we go into another realm. Oh, okay, that's how you do it. I see. All the while, all of this dream is completely flat, zero dimensionality actually, which is neither flat nor not flat. Okay, I mean, it's not conceptual, it's everywhereness, but it's pathless, it's completely pathless. You know, it doesn't have any depth to the story. It's not getting anywhere, actually. You see, a story has depth, meaning it's getting somewhere, going somewhere. There's nowhere to go. Wherever you go, it's everywhere. Wherever you go, it's everywhere. Whatever you do, it's everything. See? Whatever you are, it's allness. Wherever you are, it's everywhere. Wherever you are, it's everywhere. Wherever I am is everywhere. Wherever I am is everywhere. Wherever, okay. Sense I'm going to succeed for sure. I don't. I really don't. I got questions. I have worries. Just one moment. Okay, just to expand a little bit. Now, of course, we're told that if we back this, you know, lawyer, this new, you know, the new female lawyer, the goddess cult, who's going to break the witness supposedly, the more we back this, the happier we're going to be when it happens. It's kind of like backing a winning team. When you're a fan of that team, when they win the championship, you're like, wow, you know, and we're told we'll be richly rewarded. The higher position, yeah, everybody will be happy, golden age, but the more you back this lawyer, female lawyer, the higher your position is going to be. This is what you're told. Because it's very seductive. And you think, wow, I don't want to miss out on that. And if I don't back them, then if I don't back this, then I'm going to be like the lowest. You know, I'll be the ones cleaning up the roadkill. You know, and dealing with corpses, the untouchable, the sudra. I'll be the worst. So it scares the heck out of you. You say, well, I better support this female lord of the goddess cult. If I don't, I'm going to be on the bottom here. So that intimidates everybody here for sure. Very intimidating. Now they'll structure society that way in order to help facilitate the breaking of the witness, and they're already structuring society that way. You know, if you say anything that irritates the lawyer, you know, you're going to lose your job. You're going to have to go into sensitivity training. That's the new gulag, is sensitivity training. So you don't want to, because the Lord, you know, so you have to censor yourself constantly. Like, what do I say? What can I say? I can't say, hey, wait a minute, you know, this is not working. Sensitivity training for you. You're showing very bad attitudes. You're undermining the case. And so the stratification of society is happening already severely, depending on how much of a booster you are of this, you know, the new lawyer on the case. It's going to break the witness for sure. We've been promised that. We've been promised the witness is going to be broken, right? We're still waiting. Oh, it's tomorrow. For sure it's tomorrow. I'm going to wake up tomorrow and look at the news, and it's going to say, the witness has finally been broken. Now we know the secret. Oh, you're all going to be happy forever now. Never comes. It never comes, does it? You always spend your whole life waiting. Everybody spent their whole life waiting. It's a fact. Look at any person, all they've done their whole life is wait. You get to the end of your life and they're still waiting. Never has happened, never will happen. Existence is just an endless waiting. That's all it is, just waiting. Now you can see everyone. Again, they're all waiting. Like in the vision of oneness, I saw everyone. They're just standing kind of inert, you know, just weren't moving much or anything. They're just waiting. But I saw, too. Hallelujah. Now, but that doesn't mean that everyone is aware of their freedom. They're still waiting. But I was aware of their freedom, you see. And so they are free. We all are. All of us are free. We're no one's in any pit. We're just waiting and dreaming, waiting and dreaming, waiting and hallucinating and waiting for what will never happen. And nothing needs to happen. We're not in any pit. We don't need to know how to get out of a pit that doesn't exist. So I may, you know, see all this and be able to talk about it. It's no guarantee for me at all. I don't feel anything's guaranteed at all. I don't have some, you know, I don't have the Jesus sitting right here. Maybe Jesus is, I can't see it. But I don't have some, you know, support team that's guaranteeing my success in that way. It's not like that. Because the pressure now is so intense. You feel a little wishy-washy, you know, about any, you know, taking the stance. You feel like, wow, is this really a safe stance to take? Is this really going to work out for me? And maybe I'm really going to be in trouble. And, you know, all those thoughts go through your head. And, you know, it certainly hasn't worked out for me in terms of some sort of successful life or anything like that. But, of course, Jesus says success in life, how you measure it, we mismeasure it, you know. So maybe there has been some success, I don't know. But certainly not material success at all. Not health success. All I got is a bundle of nerves and an entire body. And no money, that's it. And nothing in the world except a broken down body. But, you know, hey, don't know. Don't know exactly what's going to happen, right? Maybe something positive will come out of this. I don't know. Or we could say for sure something positive is going to come. We just don't know what it's going to be exactly. Now, vision of oneness ultimately is it. But getting to be able to accept that, and again, it's like this pure happiness. You feel so happy, you just say, oh, I can't function in this world like that. Everybody will say, well, what happened? Did you get some news? What happens? People say, oh, you must have some good news. I mean, the lawyer, the goddess cult lawyer, broke the case, right? Has to be that. And you say, no, but yeah, that's got to be it, right? And so the whole world's going to say, well, that has to be it. There isn't any other way. This is salvation. This is what, you know, you must, how did you get the inside scoop? You got the inside scoop, huh? She must have told you first, huh? Okay, the goddess must have told you. So now you know, right? What do you say? No, nothing like that. They say, well, then you must be crazy. You must just be some kind of lunatic then, because this is the only happy source of happiness that could possibly ever happen, is for this witness to finally tell us what the secret, how they escaped the pit. So the world is convinced that this is the only source of happiness there is. So if you're just happy and say, I'm just happy for no reason at all. I'm just naturally pure happiness. So I see there is no pit. We're all free. You know, that's why I'm happy. People will just say you're completely nuts. You're completely nuts. And dangerously so, because you're leading us away from supporting the lawyer, you know. So it's like that. It's very much like that is why I see it. It's this very difficult situation. So we'll see what can be done. I don't know what can be done. It's not clear to me exactly what can be done. It's hard to say how deeply under the spell has everyone in the world fallen, you know, to how deeply. And how much are they deciding, hey, I really got to back this new lawyer because she's has to do it. It's the only way I'm ever going to be happy. See, you know, you're going to be happy by seeing the vision of oneness, which shows you there is no pit for anyone. That's the only way anyone's going to be happy. The only way. There's only one way. You have to see the vision of oneness. That's it. You have to see there is no pit. If there was any pit at all, you couldn't be happy. Because you're going to be worried. You can say, oh my God, one of us might fall into that pit. I've got to make sure, I've got to protect against this. I got worried, I got to tell everyone, hey, don't fall into that pit. You know, it's a really bad pit there. I've got to defend, you know. So you're not going to be happy. And nobody else can really be happy either because they're worried they might, you know, not see it and fall in. And if you believe in the pit that's not there, you're going to say, hey, everybody, you can't even see it. It's so subtle and deceptive. You can't even see it. You're just going to fall into it without even seeing it. And you'll be worried. So if you believe in that there's a pit at all, you can't be happy. So you have to realize there is no pit at all. It's the only way. And then, therefore, you have to see everyone as being free of any concern at all, any fear of all of ever falling in any pit. So enlightenment has to be for everyone. It has to be. It can't just be for yourself. It is for all beings. The all, total, for all. It has to be. It has to be. I was in church yesterday. They got this new prayer area where you have all these electronic candles, and they've got a little slot to put some money in. You know, I put a dollar in, and you press a little button, and the candle goes on. I said, "Hey, let's do a prayer." Okay. So I hit the candle. I was thinking, should I pray for my healing? And I said, "Hey, Jesus, God, Jesus, Holy Spirit, grace of God, save the world, save the world, save everyone in the world, please, save everybody." That was my prayer. Save everyone. And that's how we have to look at it. Save everyone. It's either everyone is saved or no one is saved. Okay? Either everyone is saved or no one is saved. Either everyone is saved or no one is saved. Either there's a pit there or there isn't. Either there's no pit or there is a pit. It's one or the other. If there's a pit, nobody's saved. If there's no pits, everyone is saved. If there's no pit, everyone is saved. Vision of oneness. That's the vision of oneness. Wow. Nothing for anyone to fall into. How absolutely wonderful. How absolutely cool that is. And of course, you can't have some secret wish for some enemy you have, like, well, I want them to fall into the pit, but nobody else. Because then you're going to be worried about everybody. You won't be happy. And you yourself be miserable. So no pit for anyone. No pit for anyone. So I'm preaching the gospel as I understand it and as best I can. And keep trying. But I certainly need some, you know, somehow something. I need some way to keep going for sure. It's really unbelievable what's going on. Weird. August 5th is like doom day for me. And then it's doom day for the world too. Coinciding is very interesting. I finally reached the bottom of the barrel, and there isn't anything more. And it's doom day for the world too. The world, August 5th is, I can't remember the Jewish name for that. Tish B'Av or something. I can't remember. But it's their official doom day also, of like, wow. History, all these, you know, the destruction, the one first temple, destruction, the second temple, expulsion from Spain, expulsion from Britain, expulsion from France, Nazis, you know, declaring, you know, this and then get this, and then all happens on this feast day, you know, all happens on this day always and throughout history for them. Doom day. It's my doom day too. It's my doom day too. Tomorrow, my doom day. So just trying to not, you know, come unglued, not panic. That's interesting that the world, what I've experienced is nobody wants to take a hard line on this situation. But you have to take a hard line. Because if you don't take a hard line, you're simply going to keep waiting. That's it. You either wait or you don't. And The hard line is to say there is no answer. There's either an answer or there's not. You see, you got to understand that taking this, not taking a hard line, is failure. It's waiting. There is no other option. It's not like you say, well, the witness has the answer, but they're going to give the answer in a little while. There is no answer. So you're waiting 100% in vain. So you're either waiting in vain, or you have a vision of oneness. There is no other option. So you have to see it that way. See what your options are, realistically. But the world doesn't want to take a hard line. They're scared. Everyone's scared. Very scared. They say, wow. You know, what if the witness does have an answer, and I didn't back the lawyer in this program of breaking the witness, then I'm going to be forever seen as a pariah, you see? That's the fear. I'm going to be a perpetual pariah. Who wants to be a perpetual pariah is the question. Nobody can handle that pressure. I can't even handle that pressure. That's why it's breaking me down, you know? Nobody wants to be seen as a perpetual pariah. And certainly, that's the fear, right? The answer to that is the witness doesn't have any answer. So you'll be a savior, not a pariah. Because you'll have the vision of oneness and you'll tell everybody, hey, there is no pit. Everything's great. And they'll feel it. At some level, they'll feel, wow. Somebody's seeing that someone's here that's seeing that everyone is saved. Not just them, you know, or a few people. Everybody's saved. Everybody's saved. Everybody's saved. Not only saved, there's never any danger in the first place. Is more than saved. You know, the idea of being saved is being saved for some danger, but there's never been any danger. So someone has realized, someone here has truly realized the truth, and then that, Jesus says, well, that'll seep into people at some level, you know. Well, sure, I reason would say that's for sure, but the seepage in the level is hard to discern, probably. But that, theoretically, of course, that must be true. Must be true. But most people say, wow, yeah, this is good, great, but, you know, I want to hedge my bets here. I don't want to, I mean, if the witness does give me an answer, I don't want to be a pariah, you see. So I want to do both. And then that's where the confusion comes into play, on where we experience the dark night of the soul. I think St. John wrote a book, St. John of the Cross, Dark Night of the Soul, or something like that. There is this time of you try to do both. You say, I don't want to take a hard line either way. I don't want to be a hardliner either way. And then you get this confusion, and you get the depression, and it tears your mind apart. You say, I can't figure out how to balance this. You know, I don't want to be a hardliner either way. And then you feel everything is tugging at you. Everything's pressuring you, you know. You can't commit to anything. It's horrible, horrible. And a lot of us are in that. I'm still in this, you know, to some extent. I'm trying to be 100% hardliner, but some aspect of me is still saying, hey, you know, don't really have the vision of oneness, because then you'll really be a pariah. You'll be the all-time pariah here. You'll join the ranks of the all-time pariahs, who will get no position in the new realm whatsoever, none. They'll be shut out. Well, that's good, because there is no new realm. I'll shut myself out, because there isn't any. Like Nisargadatta said, why do you want me to die? I'm already dead. You're talking about my death. What are you talking about? I already died. I don't need to die again. How can we be a pariah to a place that doesn't exist? How can we be a pariah in a place that doesn't exist? I was so infirm today, I couldn't even work. Didn't want to drive. Yesterday it was extremely low blood pressure. Very unstable, lightheaded, in shock, very bad. Today my blood pressure's gone back up to getting closer to normal. Still a little low, but it's getting closer to normal. And I'm a little better off today than yesterday. Yesterday was one of the all-time low points, actually. I said, wow, this is like close to failure. So So even though you hear these words and can get it, you know, you may get it, then later in the day, drop the hard line. Oh, I'm not a hardliner. That's what Jesus said to Peter. Hey, Peter, you think you're such a, you know, big deal hardliner, right? You're really with me. I guarantee you, as soon as I'm gone, you're going to deny me three times before the rooster crows in the morning. Peter said, no, I'm a hardliner for sure. I understand everything you're saying. I'll never forsake you or anything. And then Peter's, you know, like, huh? I don't know, Jesus. What are you talking about? I got nothing to do with that. I don't even know who you're talking about. I had no interest in that stuff whatsoever, you know. Not me. frantically backpedaling. Happens to everybody. Don't get down on yourself when you backpedal away from the hard line, which is the only line there is, actually. It's either one or the other. There's only a hard line here. There is no soft line. If you think there's a soft line, we're deluded to think there is. There isn't. Either the witness has an answer or the witness doesn't. The fact is, witness doesn't have an answer. Therefore, waiting is 100% in vain. I don't have a waiting problem. I do not have a waiting problem. I have a continuity problem. This is the basic confession. I do not have a waiting problem. I have a continuity problem. The waiting problem has no value to me. Only the vision of oneness has value to me, because it solves the continuity problem. You've placed yourself then into the blessedness, just like that. That's the basic confession. Make that confession. Suddenly you realize, wow, I'm dwelling in grace now. I'm dwelling in grace. And I just have to evaporate the continuity problem. You've taken a hard line when you do that. So this confession is a way to center you back in the hard line where you got to be, right? Because it's either one or the other. There is no wiggle room. It's one or the other. One or the other. Either there's another realm or there isn't. Either the spirit can... Either there is a pit or there isn't. There's no two ways about it. Okay? So there's only a hard line. So how do you center yourself in the hard line position? By the confession of the continuity problem. This is how you do it. This is how I do it. So it's the way. I do not have, you know, a confession problem. I have a continuity problem. See, I do not have a case problem. I have a continuity problem. I do not have a hard line problem. I have a continuity problem. Take all of your problems that seem to arise in this terrible dilemma we seem to be in, and put them all into just this one continuity problem. That's all that I have. And then you are taking the hard line, you see? Because you're saying no. You're saying there's only the hard line. There's only one problem. And I've already decided that there is no pit. But I have a continuity problem because of that. So you're out of the duality. When you make this confession, you're out of duality. Just like that, actually. Say, I don't have a duality problem. I have a continuity problem. I don't have a pressure problem. I have a continuity problem. Okay. You're out of duality. You only have one problem. And then grace of God works to evaporate that problem for sure. As we're doing here, this is helping evaporate that continuity fear. So for sure, you're going to get knocked off any hard line you take. The ego's going to say, hey, why are you taking such a hard line? Why don't you just kind of wait a little bit? You know, wait a little bit. And so it doesn't seem like a hard line when it says wait a little bit. But if there is no answer, the witness has no answer, then isn't any waiting at all completely in vain, 100% in vain? And the asking to wait until the witness breaks, which is what they're really saying, they wait a little while because they're ready to talk. Isn't that perpetual? Can't they keep you, once you get in that habit, can't they keep you in that habit on and on and on and on and on and on? So it's not about waiting a little while, it's about the habit of waiting, thinking that the witness is going to have some answer to give. That'll keep you waiting in perpetuity if you don't see through it. So that's a hard line for sure, isn't it? Saying wait for the impossible is a super hard line to take. Super. And they try to make it seem like, just a little waiting, just a little habit. Just wait one day at a time. See, it's not a big habit. That's the lie of the ego, as it gets these habits into you, claiming, no, just a little habit. What habit is a little habit? Is there any such thing as a little habit? I don't know of any little habit. A habit is something that continues on and on and on, and it's super hard to break. Very, very definition, a habit can't be little. You know, theoretically, habit is forever, right? Until you break it, and it's very, habits are very difficult to break. Having broken many habits, I can tell you it's hell to break habits. And we have to keep, you know, the main habit we have to break is that believing that there's such a thing as a little habit. The ego wants you to believe there's such a thing as a little habit. I just wait one day. What you're saying in there is, one, the witness has an answer. Two, the lawyer's going to break the witness. Three, this is going to happen soon. Four, this is going to make you happy. All of those suppositions are put into this so-called little habit. And that is not a little habit, because you're accepting like four basic premises that are all completely false. And so to get out of this little habit, you're going to have to break all those through all those premises, you see. They're all false. So that's a huge habit. It's a terrible habit. That's a hard line habit. So, of course, we're going to realize, hey, we got to take the hard line and realize everybody is in no condition. Everyone is completely safe. There's no pits for anyone. There's no such thing as any pits in reality whatsoever. Nobody can fall into any pit at all. Everyone's perfectly safe. Vision of oneness. Vision of oneness is the answer for us. That brings this finality to our struggle. Okay. Once we can abide in that, the struggle is over. 100% over. So that's the goal. That's the goal. The continuity fear, it gets smoothed out, and the struggle, you know, the struggle is officially over at that point. So that's our goal. There is no pit for anyone. There is no pit for anyone. There is no pit for all. There is no pit for all beings. All beings, all beings, all beings everywhere. All being. There's no pit for being. There is no pit for being. Okay? There is no pit for being. Being is zero-dimensional. I mean, there's no pit for it. There's no pit for being. There's no pit for pure spaciousness. Okay, there's nothing for pure spaciousness to fall into. There's no pit for pure spaciousness. No pit for pure spaciousness. Again, you can get this, but you'll back off the hard line, for sure, as I will, as we all do, and we think we've found a compromise. There's no compromise. There's no compromise. Either there's a pit or there isn't. If there isn't, then all this waiting is 100% in vain, and the habit of waiting has to be broken. And what you have to do it is confess, I don't have a habit problem, I have a continuity problem. The habit problem has no value to me, only the vision of oneness has value to me. You're in a state of grace then, and the grace will evaporate your continuity problem. So, okay, keep working on this, because it for sure, this all or nothing position, this hardline position, that's the choice. It's either one way or the other. Okay? You have to take the hardline position. For sure you'll fall away from it, because it seems the ego will undermine, say, hey, that's too extreme. Well, why, well, you know, I could give you something that's better. You'll fall away, and then you have to get back to it. So how do you get back to it? Continuity confession. The continuity confession is how you get back to state of grace, which is accepting that the hard line is the only line there is here. The hard line is the only line there is. Either truth is true or it isn't, you see. The hard line position is the only position there is, and from our standpoint, there isn't any other. There isn't any other. Either there's an answer, there isn't. Either spirit was in a pit, or it wasn't. There is no other two ways about it. Okay, there is no other two ways about it. Okay, so you get it, and then you back off it. You get it, you back off it. But when you back off it, you got all these false premises that you've fallen into. And then you think, oh my God, I'm so far away from the hard line, I can't figure out how to get back. No, say, I don't have a false premise problem, I have a continuity problem. So whatever problem you have, label it. Say, ah. And then say, I don't have that problem. I don't have a false premise problem. I have a continuity problem. A continuity problem is the only problem that I have. Okay, I have no other problem whatsoever. The false premise problem has absolutely no value to me whatsoever. None. Only the vision of oneness has value to me. Only the vision of oneness has value for me. And then you feel like grace is re-entered into a state of grace again, which is the hard line position of saying, there's no pit for anybody. Okay, spirit was never in any pit. There isn't any pit. It's all hallucination. I only have a continuity problem now to stop hallucinating. The content of my hallucination is not important. What's important is that I stop hallucinating. Okay, forget about the content of hallucination. It's not true. Don't worry about the content. You're hallucinating a pit. Forget about the pit. Just start. You're stopping to hallucinate more and more. You're letting go of hallucinating. All right. That's a continuity fear. It's a continuity problem, not a content problem. It's a continuity problem. And so the pathless path, the discipline, you might say, the discipline, is this getting back to grace as you get knocked off the only position you can take. The only sane position you can take is a so-called all or nothing position. Of course, there either is a pit or there are no pits at all. So of course it's all or nothing. So you can say it's hard line. Well, it's the only position you can take, one way or the other. When you take the sane position, the true position, you're going to fall away from it, you get back to it, you fall away from it, you get back to it, you fall. And it's like that. But what I'm saying is there's a way to get back to it quickly. The continuity confession. Very quickly, I use it when I'm in real trouble. That's what I go to. And there are a lot of times I'm in trouble. Like usually in the morning I wake up and I feel like I've forgotten, you know, everything. Like I'm back to ground one. All the false premises are back. And just do the continuity confession over and over and over. And gradually, suddenly, like the clouds are gone. And I say, wow, I'm back in grace. I've got my confidence back. I've got the hard line position back. This is it. Now I really can work. Wow, yeah, and I can evaporate the continuity fear. This is great. All right, well, I could go on and on and on, trying to encourage. By all means, use the continuity confession. By all means, use that. This is the essential teaching, because the more you get back into this state of grace, this feeling of grace, like, wow, I'm taking a hard line on this whole situation. Wow, I got the confidence to do this. You feel it. The more you get back to that, the quicker you get back to it, the better it's going to go for you, the quicker you're going to realize that there's no pit for anyone, for all being. Being has no pit at all to fall into. The sooner that will happen, for sure. So the quicker you can get back into it, the more consistently and you can get back into this, you know, seeing the choice for what it is. It's all or nothing. It's either true or false. It's a true or false pass-fail situation, right? There's no gradations to it, really. Sooner and quicker you get back to that, the quicker you're going to burn off your continuity fear. And that's all we're doing here, is lessening delay. That's all the Holy Spirit does, is lessen delay, help you burn the continuity fear up quicker. That's it. That's all there is here in terms of help, is lessening delay, lessening delay, lessening needless waiting. Needless waiting. Waiting for an answer that will never come. How did Spirit get out of this pit? No such answer. exists. No such answer exists. That's like saying, hey, God, how did you get out of that other realm, by the way? How did you get out of that other realm? I see you're back, you know, I see you're in reality, God, and wow, it's amazing. How did you escape from that other realm? You know, how did you do that? That's essentially what's being asked. How did you escape from that other realm, God? Wow, if you just tell me, I can escape from it too. You see? Say, God, you want me to rejoin you back in your reality? I really want to. You know, but if you just tell me how you escaped from that other realm, I'll join you like that, you know, real quick. So, that's the trick, right? There is no other realm. I was never in any other realm. I didn't escape from anywhere. I've always been here, just like you've always been here. And what else can God say? What else can God say? So, we're waiting for nothing. Waiting for nothing. Waiting for nothing. How fair is that? How fair is that to us to wait, be waiting for nothing? That's all we're waiting for. That's all we've ever been waiting for, is waiting for nothing. So if you ask, how in the world can I say all this stuff that seems such a, you know, taking such a hard line on all this, is because of the continuity practice. That's it. That's why. I'm able to get my focus back, you know, onto truth. And from there, then I can do this. But if I don't do the continuity practice, I get knocked off track like everyone else. I can't do it. I can't say anything. I don't even know what to say. I don't know what to say. I just blah, 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 blah. Sometimes I try to make a video and I can't say anything because I'm not, you know, I'm not in grace properly. But when I'm in grace like this, you can feel it. You know, it just goes on and on and on and on and on. Just flowing like that. So, you can get in grace too. When you get in this grace, you will feel like, wow. You know, I'm gonna wake up. I'm gonna be saved. I'm gonna realize. I can feel that realization is possible. I know I'm gonna do it. This is the feeling of grace. You see, realize, wow, I really don't have those problems at all. You know, those aren't the continuity problems, the only problem I have. And I'm feeling this is evaporating. I can feel it. It's gradually evaporating. And so you feel very, very, you know, like, tremendous. This is great news. I got great news for everyone. This is fantastic. And then you get knocked out. You get knocked, pulled back, you know, to off that so-called hard line, which is the only line there is. And yeah, it's like, wow, I feel like an idiot. I don't know what I'm talking about. Why was I so confident before? I can't remember. You know, maybe I was mistaken. You know, maybe I need to back that. Maybe I need to wait. I really need to be more wait for this, you know, some answer. And just, you lose all your focus, your clarity, you know, it just seems to just fall apart like a house of cards. Okay, when that happens, realize it happens to everyone, all the time, every day, just about everyone. The few who are actually abiding in vision of oneness, doesn't happen to them, really. It could, you know, it could. It may happen a few times or whatever, but, you know, but the rest of us, yeah. Best we can do is we can keep coming back to it and keep coming back to it. Now I finished this video. I don't want to stop talking because I know I'm going to get knocked off. You know, I'm going to lose my clarity. I don't want that to happen. That's brutal, 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 brutal. Because almost everyone in the world is taking what they call as a compromise position, which means what? What does that really mean, a compromise position? What do you mean? What is that? Hedging your bets, having it both ways. One of the ways is going to be entirely wrong. Okay, so you're still going to feel entirely wrong. You say, well, I'll feel half wrong because I was half right about the other. But feeling halfway is, you know, very stuck, isn't it? You'll feel very flustered no matter what happens. So everyone in the world is this way. So you're around these people constantly. How do you keep a focus? You know, it's super difficult. One moment, please. All right. So, you know, things are winding down here, and I'll get I'll get knocked back, you know, you'll get knocked back, and just have to get back to it. That's why I say the daily grind is where it's at. And this is what the ego wants to stop in everybody by promising him a pot of gold at the end of the rainbow. You just have to wait, support the lawyer, she'll break the case, and you get the answer, and you'll be happy, effortlessly happy, everyone will be happy, effortlessly happy. You see, so stop the grinding. That's what the ego wants you to do. Stop the daily efforts, stop the continual efforts. This is the whole goal of the ego, is to target you and get you to stop. That way, don't keep working at it, you see. And if you stop your daily efforts, the ego's won. You're gonna wait, for sure you're gonna wait. You'll be waiting in vain, waiting in vain. So again, use the continuity practice. I don't have a waiting problem, I have a continuity problem. The waiting problem has no value to me, only the vision of oneness has value to me. You see, and just hit that hard over and over until you really feel adamant about it. And then you will feel, wow, I'm centered again. And then you see, oh, the ego's vicious, isn't it? Absolutely vicious, trying to get me to stop. And trying to get me to stop and do what? Wait, wait, wait until the witness is broken. And the witness will never be broken, because we're saying, hey God, how did you escape from that other realm? Hey, zero dimensionality, how did you get out of that pit? There's no answer for that. Never happened. Waiting in vain, waiting in vain, waiting in vain. Okay? So, practice the continuity problem. If you're an expert at that, if you actually do it. See, the whole thing is to keep a daily practice going and keep getting back to this clarity and grace. If you act, doing it is the only answer. You know, so if you actually do it, then you're succeeding. Whereas if you don't do it, you're not succeeding. So it's a question of simply doing it. Just do it. It's super hard to think your way back into grace. It is super difficult. Continuity practice can put you there like that. Very quickly, actually. Very, very quickly, it can put you there. Sometimes it takes a little longer, but I've never seen it fail. It's never failed me. I get, wow, back to my center. Out of all this thinking, figuring, compromising. How do I compromise properly? How can I wait? How can I please both sides? How can I believe in both sides? Believe in all premises are true? And how can I detail this relativity? Figuring, thinking. No, the continuity confession takes you right out of that, back to the clarity where your mind is very clear and say, I only have a continuity problem. That's it. Vision of oneness is the only value there is for me. The vision of oneness is the only value there is for me. Okay. And then the clouds have parted and you see clearly again. You say, wow, the ego's really been trying to trick me. Wow, look at this pressure. Wow. See? And continuity fear is evaporating as you're seeing more and more clearly. Okay. Just use it, and stay on daily, intense efforts, daily. Do not get knocked off of that. The great sages will tell you, this is all important. Keep daily momentum going. Because anything else other than that, the ego has gotten a hold of you and is saying, I want you to just wait a little bit, a little habit. This is the trick, a little habit, accepting at least four false premises, huge false premises. That's not a little habit. Waiting is never a little habit. So keep the spiritual path going like this. And thanks to the sponsors of this effort, Jesus Christ, Sri Sri Anandamayama, and Guru Longchenpa, for the intensity, like this. You see, it's coming from them because they brought that intensity here, and I was able to, you know, plug into it and sink into me. Okay, so it's very important to realize it's a big effort, collective effort of many here to tell us, keep daily practice like this. Keep going. All right, and you'll be happy you did. You'll be happy you did, because you'll get clearer and clearer and clearer. All right, but keep in mind, tough times, going gets tough, the tough get going, keep your daily practice going. Very great. That's it.